Eating Disorders, Male and Female Perspective by Tommy, Tofu Tommy, and Alex Anderson. I'm going to be answering 10 questions that Tofu Tommy gave me, and in turn, Tofu Tommy is going to be answering 10 questions on his site that I gave him. Please go over and see them, they're very good. Here we go. His first question is, how did your eating disorder begin, and did you believe you had an illness or not, and did you hide it from others in fear of how you would be perceived? At the beginning, I didn't think I had an illness. It began with me wanting to disappear and feeling that fat people hurt me, because my father was 360 pounds and he molested me, and my mother was heavy and she abused me, and my sister was heavy and she abused me, and my family members were all heavy and they all ignored what was going on, and they were abusive to me as well. So I thought fat people were abusive, but I didn't think there was anything wrong with me. I did hide it from fear of how others would perceive me. Two, as a female, how does your illness affect your daily life, and do you feel it affects your relationship with your partner, family, friends, and how do you combat the behaviors, and what techniques do you use or what helps you? Well, it broke up my relationship. My girlfriend simply couldn't put up with my having an eating disorder, and I ended up breaking off the relationship because it was becoming too difficult. I don't have that many friends. I just don't, and I have almost no family that's involved with me. Techniques that I use that helps me is to talk back to the Ed voice. I go to therapy. I see a dietitian, and I see a psychiatrist. It definitely affects my relationships, though. It's made them very slim and slender. What was your experience seeking professional help? Did you go on your own accord, or were you forced to go due to being so ill? And do you feel treatment for eating disorders are good and could be improved, and if so, how? Well, seeking professional help was, it was kind of a decision that was forced upon me when I got so thin my psychiatrist at the time put me on a feeding tube. So it was taken away from me. I feel treatment for eating disorders could be a lot better. In Canada, it's basically go into the hospital, go on a feeding tube, you weigh enough, go off and leave the hospital, or do something like I'm doing, which is to get a therapist, get a dietitian. That works a little bit better, but if you're too sick and you need to be in hospital, then you need to find a hospital bed, and they tube feed you. So I feel it could be a lot better. I feel they need to take a more holistic approach and look at every aspect of the eating disorder and take a more caring approach. Have you always been open about your struggles with mental illness like you are now on YouTube? And what was your experience when you were open about your illness to others and sought help? I have another mental illness called schizoaffective disorder. And I've been ill for a long time, so I've been more open about my illness at times, and at other times I've been very closed about my illness. I've gone in and out, but now that I'm on YouTube, I'm out. And there's no more going back in. So I feel like YouTube has brought me out of the closet. And my experience when I was first open about my illness to others and sought help was, it was difficult. It was confusing and it was difficult, and it was forced upon me by my mother. Do you believe eating disorders would be preventable if more education was provided by schools about recognizing signs of mental illness and encouragement to seek help in the early stages, or that it is something genetically predisposed to, as I feel it's something that we are predisposed to, and that a traumatic event triggers the illness? I agree with you, Tofu Tommy. I believe it's something we're predisposed to, and a traumatic event triggers the illness. So I don't think we can totally get rid of eating disorders, but I do think we can help in the early stages and reduce the deficits that occur, reduce the injury that occurs. I think schools should be educating their students. I think schools should be more aware and be able to recognize the signs of mental illness. I think parents should be forced to take training on mental illness as part of parenting. And I feel that because it is something we're genetically predisposed to, we should be looking at families more closely. And we should look at triggering events. Have you found the online community for eating disorder recovery a positive experience, despite many sites like ProAnna and ProMia? And what have you done to make sure that it doesn't filter to your channel? And what do you feel should be done to stop this dangerous community? ProAnna and ProMia, if you don't know, are these sites that encourage people to become more anorexic and more bulimic. And they encourage you to become entrenched in your illness. They're very dangerous sites. I found the online community for eating disorder recovery a very positive experience. It's helping me out tremendously. I think the ProAnna and ProMia sites have to be cut down. They have to be stopped. What I've done to make sure it doesn't filter to my channel is to just monitor comments and respond to them accordingly. And I think to stop this dangerous community, I think that I think that the sites should be cut down. They should be just stopped. And every time they come up, they should be popped off. I think that they are very dangerous. What is your thoughts on people who claim that mental illness and eating disorders are a choice and that it is only rich white girls who suffer from this, as this is something that many on social media use as hate? Well, first of all, it is not only rich white girls who suffer from this. Men, women, people of color, people of all races and religions suffer from eating disorders. People of all income levels suffer from eating disorders. And these people who play this game that little rich white girls decide to starve themselves are dangerous. They use it as hate. They use it as a way to try to minimize the severity of eating disorders, and they are dangerous. They are as dangerous as the pro-Mia and pro-Anna sites. What are your recovery mental health goals for the next few months, and where do you want to be by this time next year and for your YouTube channel? And are you religious, as I feel it plays a big part in recovery also, and also my vegan lifestyle? Over the next few months, I want to stop purging, and I want to start getting my eating down comfortably so that I'm eating food three meals a day and three snacks, and I want to be able to do it comfortably. And a year from now, I would like to be doing that without thinking about it. My YouTube channel, I would like it to grow. And I would like it to grow a lot so that I can help more people. I would like to be where Shani is now, at 50,000 people, so that I can grow to help more people. I am religious. I was Jewish, and I converted to Catholicism last Easter. And it does play a big part in my recovery. It also plays a big part in my vegan lifestyle as well, but especially in my recovery. Do you feel it is fully possible to recover from an eating disorder, or that you just need to find ways to deal with your illness? As some say, it's like an alcoholic or drug addict, but in those cases, they can abstain from the drugs and alcohol. But we have to face our demon daily, as that is what we need to live, which is food. I've had an eating disorder for 40 years. And I've never recovered. I feel like we need to find ways to deal with our illness. And we have to face our demon daily. But I feel like we can do it in more comfort than I have, and in more control than I have. I feel like we have a chance at a normal life, something that I haven't had. And 10, what do you hope to achieve from sharing your story on YouTube? And what is the one thing you would say to someone suffering in silence? And is there any recovery quotes that speak volumes to you? Sharing my story on YouTube, I hope to help others to not go down the path that I've gone down, but to recover and learn to live with the disease, and to feel safe and in control. If you're suffering in silence, please come out of the woods. Speak up. Don't suffer in silence. Speak up. And there are no recovery quotes that speak volumes to me. It's been too many years and too many decades. So I don't have a recovery quote. But I believe we can all recover together. I believe we can all do this together. And that is the end of my 10 questions. And I hope you enjoyed the answers. Now remember, if you're new to the site, please click on the subscribe button and the bell. The bell gets you news about when there's new videos on the site, and it also keeps you subscribed. If you don't hit the bell, YouTube sometimes unsubscribes you, and you don't want to be unsubscribed without knowing it. And I love y'all.